Ian, the Oval, another Ashes win, but a fantastic innings first up, I suppose. That was almost worth 150 when you look at the state of the wicket in the end, wasn't it?
Yeah, no, it was nice to make a good contribution in the first innings. You know, it's a great game. You know, we knew what we had to do when we turned up here. You know, we didn't put a great performance in at Headingley, and things just went perfectly for us this test. You know, and there's some great performances this week, and just great to be a part of it again. You know, to win the Ashes again for the second time is absolutely a dream come true. You know, it's unbelievable.
You mentioned sort of after that innings that it felt like a 3-day wicket. Did you have a sneaky feeling that things were going to get quite tough for the Aussies and that you were really in with a good opportunity to push home?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, I think it's my fifth test match here at the Oval, and I honestly did believe that, you know, this was a wicket like we've never played on before here. And, you know, I honestly, you know, it's amazing to go out there, because normally here you get in, as long as you get in and you know, spend a good time at the crease, it becomes a great place to bat. And this one just never got any easier. And, you know, there's something, I don't know what it was, but I just knew that it wasn't an easy pitch to bat on. And, you know, it was just, you know, the whole feelings the last 5 days, or 4 days, I guess, is... It's been absolutely amazing. You know, it's actually better than 2005. It's just been brilliant.
Well, you mentioned, I mean, the crowd, the sunshine. There was a feeling that it was bubbling. Once Haddin was dismissed, there was a feeling it was going to happen tonight. Explain that moment. Obviously, the last backpack catch was taken. Swanee disappeared off, God knows where. What was it like? I mean, what was going through your head, if anything, I suppose?
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, me and Cookie, I was looking at Cookie saying, I want the ball. So, and unfortunately, he caught the catch, put the ball in his pocket and ran off. So, a bit disappointed with that, but, you know, unbelievable again. Like I said, the crowd here at the Oval has been absolutely amazing. You know, the pitch, you know, it went our way, you know, great again. I mean, you know, when you beat Australia, it's a special thing, because they're a fantastic side. They don't give you anything lightly at all. You know, I mean, going to Australia, losing 5-0 for me was one of the lows of my career. You know, we got absolutely hammered, and you know, to come here again now and win is, you know, it's pretty special. And being lucky enough to be in 2005, to have it again, I think these are times you just got to, you know, just actually spend that bit more time actually savouring the moment, because they don't come around very often, and it's a real special time.
And just finally, you know, I'll let you get off and enjoy the celebrations, but for you personally, obviously coming back into the side at Edgbaston, a half century there, obviously the team a disappointment at Headingley, but then to come and contribute in a fantastic win here, it must be great. I mean, must sort of, just for all that work you did in the winter, for example, fitness work and things like that.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, my point when I got back, you know, I know my record against Australia hasn't been the best against everyone else. It's been pretty good, I knew I wanted to come in and prove a point, and you know, Headingley was a disappointment. We probably got the rough end of the wicket in a way, but you know, first innings here at Headingley, I want to stand up and be counted, and I think I did that, and I think I proved a few people wrong, and it's fantastic to be a part of, and actually put a performance in that actually got us in a position to win. So I mean, you know, absolutely fantastic, and going to enjoy tonight, enjoy the next couple of weeks, and then look forward to moving on and like putting England towards the top of, I guess, the ICC rankings. Really, it'll be amazing.